The next leg in our preparation is about building a comprehensive understanding of cash flow statement. So the process we are going to follow, I'm going to do a series of examples with you. I think on my file I have about 12-13 examples, and when you revise for the exam, this Excel file would be available on the system for download. Okay, so you just revise these 13 examples, and they've covered every possible scenario of question that might be tested. And it will also cover most of the theory questions as well, numerical as well as theory. So your revision strategy is revise these 13 examples. You don't have to write questions. The Excel file is available for download. So don't spend time there. Just write the solutions properly. And then towards the end, we will spend some time on theory. So these 13 questions plus theory and your job is done. Okay, so let's start with question number one. Now, question number one, we will spend some time on first building income statement, then we will build a balance sheet, and then we will build a cash flow statement. Okay, so let's do it together. So this is our balance sheet and this is our income statement. I'm going to ignore the presentation, just focus on the concepts. Now, step number one, you're starting a new business, you've put in capital into your business. Okay, so typically it should be a part of your equities. So on the left hand side, I'm going to write equity and liabilities. On the right hand side, I'm going to write expenses. Here on the income statement, I'm going to write income on the right hand side, expenses on the left hand side. So capital is at 2.5 million. Yes, so let me just write contributed capital 2.5 million. Do you think this should have a second effect? Yes, it should be in cash. So now we have a cash 2.5 million. This is referred to as double entry system of accounting. Then bank loan 1.5, where should we write this? So bank loan, I'm leaving out some space for reserves. Bank loan is 1.5. Second effect will be what? Cash. So your current cash, which is 2.5, will become 4. In real world, we built a separate account for cash. And then we take the final balance, put that on the balance sheet. But I'm going to do that here itself. Then land and building. So let me just call them as L and B. L is for 2 and B is for 1.5. So total is 3.5. So your cash will now become how much? 0.5. So now cash becomes 0.5. Okay. Then sales 8 million. Where should we write this? Income statement. So sales is 8. And have we received the entire cash? No. So how much of cash have we received? 4. So 50% of this 8 is what we've received in cash. So my cash, which is currently 0.5, I'm going to make that as 4.5. But then how about remaining 4? AR. So we show AR of 4. General expenses 0.5. Second effect, cash now becomes 4. Then total salary expenditure during the year 1 million. So let me write down salary 1. But have we paid entire amount in cash? No. How much we paid in cash? We've paid cash. Total salary expense 1, but 0.2 is still outstanding. So how much did we pay in cash? 0.8. So your cash now will become how much? 3.2. This is cash payment. So it will reduce, it will become 3.2. But how about that remaining 0.2? It's a liability. So we will show outstanding salary, a current liability of 0.2. Depreciation on fixed assets 20%. So we should charge depreciation on land and building both. Depreciation only on building. On land, there is no depreciation. So then we will say minus depreciation and 1.5 minus 0.3. So now this becomes 1.2. What should be second entry for depreciation? Expense. So we will have a depreciation expense which would be of how much? Depreciation expense of 0.3. Now, just a minute. Okay. So once this is done, we do the finalization. So finalization is to first figure out what is the amount of profit we've made. So your sales is 8, your total expenses are 1.8. So how much is the amount of profit? 6.2. And then we take this profit, and this profit gets transferred where? retained earnings as a part of equity. So retained earnings 6.2, and then we take total on the balance sheet 10.4 and 10.4, and then your balance sheet tallies. How many of you were able to tally the balance sheet here? Okay. So if you want to really appreciate cash flow statement, you need to be good at this. If you understand how this works, then cash flow statement is going to be very easy. Any part you want me to repeat again here? Please be honest. It's okay to spend time, but make sure you understand everything that we've done. Any adjustment you are not comfortable with, please ask. So now we build the cash flow statement. So look at this carefully now. So cash flow statement. Now tell me, what was the amount of cash we had at the beginning of the year? At the beginning of the year, how much cash did we have? Zero. Why? Because it's a new business. So there was no cash at the beginning of the year. At the end of the year, how much cash do we have? 3.2. So what do you think should be the total of three numbers? CFO, CFI, CFF. It is going to be 3.2. So let's start doing it. Cash flow from operations, cash flow from investments, and cash flow from financing activities. Number one, capital. Where should we write this? So raising capital, is it an operating activity or investing or financing? Financing. Okay. One easy way to think is, generally those items which are related to this liability section, excluding current liability, those items which are related to liability are generally a part of CFF. Those items which are related to asset side are generally a part of CFI. And those items which typically go on income statement are part of CFO. This would just help you kind of remember things easily. Are we okay? So raising capital, it's a part of financing activity. So a positive 2.5. Raising bank loan is, come on, tell me, financing activity again. So this is positive 1.5. Then buying land and building is investing activity. So this is going to be negative 2. Now it's a cash outflow. Money is going out. So negative number. Building is going to be negative 1.5. I'll give you time to write. Just observe. Sales 8. But did we receive the whole amount in cash? No. So we just received 4 in cash. So therefore, sales is going to be a inflow, but just 4, not 8. We're only concerned with cash. Then general expenses 0.5. Where should we write this? It is an operations, but it's a negative item. So negative 0.5. Total salary is 1 million, but how much did we pay in cash? 0.8. So I'm just writing the cash component. That's 0.8. And where should I write depreciation? Where should I write depreciation? Nowhere, because it's a non-cash expense. Right? We do not pay out cash. So that's it. Your cash flow statement is done. So let's take a total of these three numbers. So your CFF is positive 4. CFI is negative 3.5. And this would be how much? 2.7 positive. Then 2.7 plus 4, 6.7 minus 3.5, 3.2. Okay, this is how we build cash flow statement. So all the presentation, formatting, all that part we will learn later on. Just get hold of the logic here. So let's do question number 2. Okay, what I want you to do is leave out some space for this question. There is one more part that we need to do, but we'll do it later on. So just leave out some space that I guess about 30% of one page will do the job, about 8 to 10 lines.